So what generally makes a boxer punch harder than anyone else, even if they're smaller? We see the power that they generate is a bit extraordinary. Now, the simple answer for this is they're more experienced and they learn the necessary technique to punch harder, and it's through repetitions of getting the dexterity and creating that snapping motion when throwing a punch. And what this snappy motion is, it's mostly fast twitch and an explosion when throwing a punch. And it also comes through form. Form in a punch is one of the most critical aspects into generating huge punching power. Sometimes you'll see a wrestler or a BJJ guy who's a bigger person, has more muscle, and weighs maybe 200 pounds. But for some reason, they cannot punch as hard as a 160 or a 150 pound professional boxer. And boxers develop the greatest way to throw a punch, or the greatest form to throw a punch, because there are karate punches and reverse punches and all these other ways of punching. But the straight right hand, the cross, the hooks, the uppercuts, and all these other punches, the form is much greater to deliver power and speed. Now, this comes through repetition of what they do. Boxers develop the form and develop the dexterity in the shoulders throughout their whole career. Since they threw their first punch in the gym till their last punch, they always build on the dexterity and the form. Where most other people, when they throw punches, it's more of a pushing punch. The arm motion, it's pretty much like pushing the other person, but a bit faster. Now, when a boxer goes and throws a punch, the form that they use is they take a solid and balanced stance. Now, usually the power punch is the rear hand. So in this case, when throwing a straight right hand in an orthodox stance, they twist their hips and their shoulders, creating the torque, lift the back heel off the floor, balance on the ball of the back foot as if you're going to explode out from a sprint and be planted on the ground with the lead foot, putting more weight on that foot for support on the punch, and then very quickly throw the right shoulder over past the left shoulder, and as the shoulders are in that motion, extend the right hand forward, and not outward with the elbows out, but forward, and then twist the arm counterclockwise really quickly, and right at the end of the punch, explode with that rotation of the arm and then retract. This is a general motion to the power right straight from an orthodox fighter. This whole motion to this punch is done all at once and only all at once. And if all these steps are not done at once, the power is decreased. If you go by the steps, go on the ball of your foot, shift the hips, the shoulder as well, but then you don't throw the punch at that exact moment and you wait a little bit and then you throw your arm after all those steps, it pretty much resets the power into the shoulder, and then it resets it coming from the shoulder to the fist, decreasing it significantly. But this is natural for a boxer. They don't even think about any of this. When they throw a right hand, they do all these movements instinctively. It's like tying your shoes, right? When you tie your shoes, you don't really think about it, right? You just do it. Same thing with these punches from a boxer. It's just built into their brain. Now, what other people, such as people who have never trained before, people who aren't boxers or aren't from a striking sport, a lot of times when they throw punches, either they don't take a solid stance, they forget to lift the back foot, which is very critical. Lifting the back heel off the ground is one of the most important things to deliver this power. It creates the explosiveness. And all the power comes from the legs. People think it comes from the arms. It comes from the legs, starting at the base of the feet. And you just carry it through your body and end it through the fist. A lot of people, they think it's all in the upper body. So what they do is they just throw the punch out from where they're standing. And what they do is they twist the shoulders first to the point where their right shoulder is farther than the left. But then they throw their punch after that, not during it, which completely takes away a lot of the power. You see a lot of people, you look at street fight videos on the internet, a lot of people, they twist their shoulders and then they wing out their haymakers or something, which decreases the power significantly because you're not carrying that power through. The power, it starts at the feet, goes to the hips, the torque happens, goes up to the shoulders, and then it stops because you don't follow through with the punch. It's a slight pause and then they throw out their arm punch. And then the power generates all over again through the shoulders and then through the fist instead of going throughout the whole body. That's when they throw haymakers and hooks, and they usually keep their arm really wide out there. But when you see boxers throw hooks, their elbow's almost at a 90 degree angle and they follow through when they turn their shoulder over. And there's a term of when other people just throw their punches out there by turning their shoulders and then throwing their arm out, or throwing their arm out from where they're standing. Those are called arm punches. To professional boxers' eyes, they're pretty amateurish. Now, through all the form and the snapping on the punches and the explosiveness that they build up later, those can increase anybody's punching power. But punching power itself is intangible. You know, some people are just born natural punchers. Same reason why some people are born to run quicker than others. But you can work on it, right? You can work on the form, which makes you that much faster, which makes you hit that much harder. That's why you see smaller boxers hit harder than big guys who don't really train in boxing. Although that big guy that doesn't train in boxing, if he decided to train in boxing and dedicate some time to develop that punching power, he would most likely punch harder than the smaller guy. The form and all these factors that go into punching power that boxers develop, it is a huge impact on increasing that punching power. It doesn't necessarily increase punching power, it allows you to deliver it more effectively. Those are why boxers develop this punching power. Experience, they train it all the time, it's easy for them. They get the endurance to where they can keep throwing power punches over and over again. They learn the form, which is one of the most important things, and they learn how to snap their punches instead of pushing them through. The snap is pretty much the explosion in the punch. It's pretty much snapping your arm forward and back really quickly. Pushing is you throw your arm out there and you labor it. You're forcing your arm out there. That's a push punch. Those can hurt, of course, because you're still hitting someone, but it doesn't have the necessary power to knock someone out. So those are the factors into why boxers punch harder than anyone else. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoy my content, make sure to subscribe. I'm coming up with different videos than my usual breakdown videos. I got a few others coming out, so be on the lookout for those. And again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.